Hello and welcome to my presentation. My name is Cor Middelkoop and I'm product manager pot orchids by Royal Flora Holland, the Dutch flower and plants auction. First of all, I want to thank the organization of the Taiwan International Orchid Show for the invitation to be one of the speakers. I feel honored to be able to tell you something about the development of pot orchids in the Netherlands during the 2021 TIOS World Orchids Business Forum in Tainan, and I'm happy to do so. Unfortunately, this time from a distance, due to Corona measures, I cannot be present at your fantastic orchid show in your beautiful country, but maybe next year. In the following presentation, I will tell you something about the development of the market from pot orchids in the Netherlands. It's a few with figures and photos and graphics in the year 2020. And 2020 was a very, very strange year, but that will not come as a surprise for you. The total turnover of pot orchids last year, 2020, was considerably high, with 445 million euros and 120 million pieces. We have the house plants as the highest turnover of all. But the annual turnover was 6.2% lower. And that's caused by less production. A view we saw in 2019, the year before, already. In 2019, we saw the first signs of reduction of production in more than 20 years. Every 20 year, we saw more production, but in 2019 and also in 2020, less production. Still, it's a considerably high amount of plants and a considerably high amount of turnover. The pot orchids are still very, very popular in the Netherlands and in Europe, especially the Phalaenopsis. That's the reason why the turnovers are so high and the amount of plants production also high. However, the share of the pot orchids in the total market of houseplants is declining further. You can see that in the sheet. It's the benefit of the share is by green plants. The green plants are at this moment becoming more and more popular, and for orchids it's rather stable. I told you in this presentation before, the amounts of pot orchids and especially Phalaenopsis is decreasing. Also in 2019 and 2020, the downward trend of 2019 will continue in 2020. In totally, there were 13.4 million pieces less traded by Royal Flora Holland. But that is not all caused by less production of Phalaenopsis. In 2020, the Corona pandemic started in Europe in week 12. From week 12 to week 17, there was no possibility for selling Phalaenopsis, pot orchids, or whatever. All the lockdowns in Europe caused that a lot of production of pot orchids and all the houseplants has been thrown away. There was no possibility for sales. The 13.4 million pieces less traded by Royal Flora Holland, I show you before in this presentation, was not all reduction of production. The pandemic, the Corona pandemic, caused that we misses 4 or 5 million pieces by one, cutting back the spikes, with the possibility that they give spikes back approximately 30 weeks later, but mostly of throwing away a lot of many batches. That is not a nice view, and that's not a nice story to tell of throwing away a lot of batches. However, the benefit of lower production was that the price of Phalaenopsis became better. And this sheet shows you an increasing of 6% better price. The scarcity of Phalaenopsis caused by the Corona makes that the price was going up. Traders were buying a lot of Phalaenopsis in the following weeks, also in the summer. And the summer is not always a good period for selling, but the Phalaenopsis became more and more popular last year, And that makes that the price was a lot higher than the year before. The scarcity also caused that there was less supply in front of the clock. And that's an important fact because the clock determines the daily trading. When there is too much supply for the clock, the price went down, is going down. When there is low supply for the clock, the price went up. And this sheet shows you that there is in 2020 30% less supply in front of the clock. And that causes that the price in front of the clock increases with 70.5%. The corona pandemic in 2020 causes that for 5 or 6 weeks, a lot of production is thrown away. I show you before. That's why all the pot sizes, which are Phalaenopsis in cultivated, shows you a negative figures. Overall, we can say that the most important pot size for cultivating Phalaenopsis still is the 12 centimeter pot, and that the cultivation in 15 centimeter pot is very, very low at this moment. Overall, we can say that the smallest pot sizes, 6 and 9 centimeters, decreased proportionately the least. More than 60% of all the Phalaenopsis are cultivated with two flower spikes. Mostly decreasing is the one spike. The growers in the Netherlands go more towards a higher quality of the Phalaenopsis. And we see that in the increasing of tree spikes on a plant. That's what becomes more popular in Europe and in the Netherlands. With regard to the other orchid species, other species than Phalaenopsis, they also decreases in trade by Royal Flora Holland. This sheet shows you that its amount of 1.3 million pieces. And all the other species like Cymbidium, Meltonia, Oncidium, this group totally has a share of 10% of the total pot orchids. So what I'm trying to tell you is that 10 of the pot orchids which are sold in Europe, 9 of them are Phalaenopsis and one is another species. But that makes the group of other species orchids not less important. Because with a total turnover of 55 million euros, it's a very, very important group. And also, the turnover and the average price was higher than last year with the other species of orchids. Many growers of other types of pot orchids than Phalaenopsis prefer to sell directly to the buyer because the price difference on the clock and by direct selling. The difference is too big, it's too high. Buyers on the clock do not value the types of orchids at the right financial way. Therefore, it's good to see that the amount of supply before the clock was also by other pot orchids species in, decreasing. What particularly striking is about this sheet. Is that in the group of other orchid species than Phalaenopsis, the balance of price and production is very fragile. You can see that when there is more supply, when there is more production, the price will fall down, and the other way around. When there is less production, the price will increase. That makes it that is a very fragile balance. In this group of other orchid varieties than Phalaenopsis, the largest share is by Dendrobium nobile with 30%. Last year, in 2020, there was more production of Cymbidium, Cambria, and Oncidium, and there was less production of Dendrobium nobile, Cattleya, Meltonia, and Ludicia. I will end this presentation by some expectations for this year, 2021. And these expectations are based on a normal year and not with too much influence of possibility of a corona pandemic. The expectations are further reduction of the production of Phalaenopsis. Not as much as last year, because we have to throw away a lot of batches, I show you, caused by the corona pandemic. But the reduction of production is important for a better price. And so the further reduction of Phalaenopsis, we estimate about 7% less than in 2019, because we compare with 2019, the reduction of production will cause a better price again for the Phalaenopsis. The price of Phalaenopsis will improve. The amount of tree spikes will also increase and bring the quality of the plant over a higher level. Sustainable production is becoming even more important for the European customers. New variety and flower colors remain very, very important. So we need your help from Taiwan to develop new colors and new varieties. The price of production of other orchid species will remain the same as we know. Many thanks for your attention for my presentation. Unfortunately, there is no possibility for asking questions, but I hope there is a possibility that we meet each other in the future at the Taiwanese International Orchid Show and we can discuss about pod orchids. Thank you very much.